On the 15th of September 1986, 183 potential apprentices arrived here at Junior Company to begin the basic military training that is required of every entrant to the British Army, whether he be infantry or technician.
£5
your next wage packet, £5 in 10, £5 in 15. Any questions?
No. The next call the call's over there by the right.
Well, come here. I used to have a really quarterish haircut. It was, you know, all used hair gel and everything on it. A few days before I come though, I had a skinhead cut. It was really bad. But it took a lot of time to get used to. And when I arrived at the college, all the other lads had long hair, really. And I thought, oh no, I could have kept the style. But about half an hour or so later, I saw all the lads coming out from the corner where the barber had been hairdressing, and they looked virtually the same as me.
Issued with clothing and equipment to the value of over £900. It is his responsibility to look after and maintain all items issued from this moment on.
One set of wet weather. A pair of gloves. One respirator. Four pairs of socks. Two vests, two shorts, two red, one white PT, two towels, a these are for your steel helmet. One pair of braces. Two long johns. One head over and two ties. And one kit bag when you pack that all away. And some bayonets on.
Once the recruit has settled in to his new surroundings, he is taught how to look after his clothing, which he has been issued with, and his room, which he shares with three other recruits.
Cleaner, we get up early in the morning and just before breakfast we dust the room regularly, every day. We also sweep the rooms out, sweep under the beds, under the tables. We polish the windows and we also do block jobs about the building. Clean the toilets, the utility room, we wash the clothes. After we'd been issued kit and uniforms, we were shown how to lay our military locker out. We had two lockers. After we had the military locker, we were shown we had to lay it out and fold it in certain ways on shelves and hang shirts up and press them neatly.
First coming to college, it's a bit weird coming into the system and having to build up a standard of the room being kept clean, your lockers, things like that. And generally, every week, you get so many inspections, and the inspections consist of the officers or your section sergeant or whatever coming in and inspecting your room, opening your lockers and looking at your kit. Your kit's got to be kept to a certain standard inside your locker, i.e. clean, well maintained, stuff like that. Your bed lock, you've got to have blankets and sheets folded in a certain way on your bed lock. Your pillows sat on top of your bed lock in a certain way. And your counterpane folded and sat on top in a certain way as well. But they inspect these, and if these aren't up to standard, then you're told to do it again, and you can sort of take the consequences in a way.
Bulb? It's a diffuser.
Diffuser, no, it also got a hidden brushes hidden either under the bed or in the spinner like that.
Why have you got two brooms in this room? Are you privileged? You are.
Also, this is purely for your letter writing. All your spare rubbish.
Biscuits and your peanuts. You've got more fluff in there. In fact,
you've got more rubbish in there than there is in the skip outside the vast plastic barracks block.
Is that why
an intent meeting. Still again, never use this fourth blanket. The bed blocks seem to be going a bit.
That's it.
A bag of worms. Where's your drawer?
Come on.
Where is it?
I'll fix it
today. You make sure that
it's drawn.
Behind the radiators, one sauna, a top locker, and your drawer. Look for you, look.
Yes, sir.
And behind your bed. And rubbish in the bin. McPhee, you're working the right way to end up going up the road.
McPhee already went there yesterday, sir.
Did he?
Did you learn anything, McPhee?
Yes, sir. What did you learn?
Not to work hard.
Yes. Well, it looks like you're letting yourself go again, doesn't it? That was only yesterday, sir.
Discipline also extends to the playground.
Arrive at the college, you find out that there's a lot of discipline, and most of the discipline is contained in your drill. You start off with your section sergeant taking out on the square and trying to teach everybody the first step, stepping off on the certain feet, everybody getting numbered from left to right and getting numbered in a section in drill positions. You have the first sort of steps you learn are just stepping off left, right, left, and you find that many people seem to start stepping off and their right arm swinging with their right leg and their left arm swinging with their left leg, and the sergeants sometimes get a bit agitated, and then after that you sort of lead on up to other pieces where you've got to maybe use 7 different movements building up and eventually complete the movement. Once you've completed these movements and that, you start to feel a bit proud and you get a bit of swagger going, and your section sergeants usually get quite pleased with you. And they'll have you going around the square again and again until they're happy with it. Drill can be a bit boring at times, but when it's done right and when it's done properly, then your section looks very smart, and it's what the army's all about.
First, I found drill quite difficult because it's all about coordination, and I didn't realise it was done by numbers or anything until we came here, and then we learned it by numbers to help get the movements correct and sharp enough and fast enough, and then when you pass up the square and I think you're good enough, you don't have to call out the timings anymore because I think you can do it without calling out the timings. And after that,
the standard of drill is tested in week 4 when the recruits pass off the square.
247, 25, 325, apprentice station, Matthew, V, enter. You've obviously worked hard. Well done, Matthew. And that's a good turnout.
2471, 465. Junior leader, Dawson. Combat medical technician, first.
Do you know who the director general is of the IMC?
This in the rear rank. Rear rank!
Passing off the square in week 4 is one of the most important parts of the whole training, really, because the first 4 weeks you're wearing stupid hats and you feel like an idiot walking around the place, and you have to march up and down the corridors and things like that. But then you do the pass off on the 4th week and you get your berets. First of all, you have an inspection by usually quite a high-ranking officer, and that's very breathtaking there. You know, you don't know what to do there. You're fidgeting that, look, you're standing about for so long.
Let's go.
Apprentice Greenwood, vehicle mechanic, sir.
What position are you playing, soccer?
Red wing or red fan, sir. Red fan.
What do you think of the
team? Really helpful, sir. Red fan.
2478-5207.
Strength of spearsman. Strong. Vehicle mechanic, sir.
Hold it up. Look up. Try not to tense up, though. Don't hold your breath. You can still breathe, okay? Just relax a little bit.
You've been washing your jersey a lot.
Not fluffy over there. You should be very careful, they're very expensive. 3472-5347, apprentice and nothing. Electronic permission, sir. Give this piece a little bit further apart now. Pick it up. Hold it back. 3472-5370, apprentice trade and calling. Aircraft technician, sir.
Down the square, I'll right wheel you. Come right across the centre, I'll halt you, I'll advance you, and I'll begin the open order. I'll then go and ask the inspection officer for permission to carry on. I'll come back to you, and then we're in. We're going for it. Hot and strong. Hard work. enjoy it. If you enjoy what you're doing out there, it will increase your performance no end. 20 hard minutes, or you'll be back later, like what's happening to the others today. Let's go for this morning, lads. On the heels now, keep your dressing by the look up everywhere. Get on the heel. Drop the arms into the elbows. By the right! Right wheel! Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left.
And then they actually do the drill. It's quite good. I feel really proud while you're doing it, because you're doing it down on the depot square, which is really enormous, and you're marching around and you've got the CSM and the OC and all the high people from the platoon and that are there.
Miss, over, two, three, four, five, down, three.
Left, right, left.
squad! Up, get 1, 2! Above, get 1, 2, 3, 1! Standard, and out!
Slim, mid, up, 2, 3, 4, 5, down, 3! Left, right, left, right.
Out, check, 1, 2! Airball! Set, 1, 2, 3, 1! Standard! Eight, out!
Up, 2, 3, 4, 5, down, 3! Left, right, left.
Squad! Out, check, 1, 2! Applause! Count! 1, 2, 3, 1! Standard! 8! Out! 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, down, 3!
Left, right, left, right, left, right, left!
Good! Hold, check! 1, 2! Over! 10! 1, 2, 3, 1!
Standard! 8!
Out! Squad! Halt! Check! 1, 2! About! 10! 1, 2, 3, 1!
Stand up! It's when you form up on one side and you march past in threes, past the commanding officer, and if one of you, one of the three does it wrong, then, you know, they can fail the whole, all three, or the whole platoon if it's that bad. So it's pretty nerve-wracking, really, to do it. But once you get your bearings, it's a lot better. You feel like you can, around the college and things, you can merge in with all the people at the canteen and that lot. It's just like your shoulder flashes. That's the only way they can tell you, you know, you've just started.
Hold on. Right. Hold on.
Later on in the term, the boys have a drill competition. The competition is between Alamein, Blenheim, Cambrai and Dettingen. The inspection is carried out by the adjutant, and the inspection of the drill is carried out by the regimental sergeant major.
Sport plays a very important part in the physical training of lads in junior company. Today we have the first of the sports, which is the cross country run.
Go on, get in front of him, council position. Go on, let's bring in 50 yards. Go on, go. Go.
Second, my name is Matthew.
well run. Keep going.
Get up, you scared, get up! Hand your sickies in, come on, get up! No good lying down here, you only...
We now move on to field craft. The recruit spends a total of 9 nights in the field whilst in junior company. This is split into 3 exercises, the first being a 2-day exercise. Exercise milk teeth.
This thing to be, the big packs at the bottom, the level at the bottom, you just go there. I've got no blanket.
Kilo, bravo, bravo.
Just.
Will be. Right, come in. Right, it's virtually 12 o'clock, 32, and 10 and 2 o'clock at this position. Alright? So, password kilo, kilo, bravo, bravo. Alright? Good. Alright? So, your left and right of arc is 10 and 2 o'clock at each corner. Kilo, kilo, bravo, bravo is the password. Alright? That kit pack to work, shouldn't we, hanging out?
What is this?
Mike, find out what it belongs to. Get that pig packed away. If we finish with it, everything should be packed away.
Same with you.
Action. Isn't that nice?
Right, please.
That'll work to be charged for it.
Two walls. The hooks of your bungees.
Let's go have the sentinels on. Pull it tight. Right, about this side. Put it on the same level. Ah, yeah, that's it. Right, now put it on there. I'll just peg the corners in. Have a lean to because the wind is coming up this way. The way the tent is slant, or the bash is slanted, the wind will nip it, okay? No, you'll all be gonking under there. You have 1 centi per section. Get the hood on a piece of string pointing up so you get a top.
He's still got spare bungee.
Tree there. As we said before, lads, use one ground sheet.
Well, one of the good things is the bivvies.
a lot of people were trying to put bivy darts, some of them upside down, some were inside out, you know, the type of thing. The elastic's dropping off. But, I mean, it didn't rain that night, so it wasn't too bad. But army sleeping bags are quite warm and comfortable, so you have to at least wrap your bib around usually.
I think the greatest delight we all found was opening up ration packs, and as soon as we got them, everyone was opening up and eating the chocolate, then sort of suddenly realising that was part of the food for the whole day. And they opened up the tins the first time, and some of the looks on the faces were a bit different.
Four men, you got Pete?
I don't know.
I got beef.
Bob!
You got your mess in bed.
Right, I trust you now, leaving you on your own. You know, Colvin.
Wedge fingers, Pete. Pierced them?
No, I didn't even dent it.
Pierced them, otherwise they'll blow.
It is my knife.
And my water.
Wear it. Dog meat. This tastes like dysentery. It looks like pedigree.
There it goes, spilling everywhere.
Make a disgusting face.
Some people thought that said it looked like pedigree chum, tasted like pedigree chum, and you'd be sent home with dysentery. But we soon found out it was a bit different. But it's quite a bit different. It was a new experience. Most people haven't been out for 24 hours at any one time and having to get up at 2 o'clock in the morning to lie on wet earth and look out for an enemy or something like that. But most of them found it a bit different.
Look at it.
What is it, curry chicken?
Oh god, show that to the camera. He's trying to work out how to do it.
That tree, innit? My tree, you need my tree alone.
That water's hot.
Oh, it's gone back in there.
Get back, are you sure that's drinkable?
I don't care, it's going down my throat.
Got it. Got it.
Finish.
Oh, yeah, right.
Which is which weather, do you know?
Yeah, sure.
Remember, keep that for your missus. Oh, God.
Wait, go and get that head screen off your
heart. Yeah. That's gonna go lumpy.
Okay.
Upset his mother.
Where are we going to owe you?
Yeah. Where I just laid my kitchen.
Evening, sir.
Yeah. Got a camera up the position. Special dirt everywhere, sir.
That's got bits in it.
That's not too bad. When does the sentry come in?
Not yet.
Last line. When you get sent to the sentry, it comes back in, alright? That's the daytime, so why isn't there anybody there now? What did I tell you down there? All three sections for the sentry out. So you've made a position for him, have you? Right, do your sentry then from your corner position. Two on there at a time. Daytime, one, up here. Go and get your two IC and get him to sort something out.
But
have a look at him.
It's just got the order, it doesn't got any specific times at the
moment. Well, let's start working on some times then, shall we? Or we're going to start tomorrow morning. Right, start working on times.
As of 5:30?
I want one on here, 5:30. When you're starting to get ready for stand two, then you can call him back in. And then you'll work from that corner position. That will be your sentry call.
You're safe, we've just come in that area, aren't we?
Have we been past this way?
No.
Do we know that area is clear?
No.
We've done a clearance before, but you didn't go very far out. So you don't know that that is clear. So this would be a damn good place to have a sentry, I would have thought. Likewise, that one on the corner there, the other section. Right, that's unknown territory to you. Each section calls to the sentry. Forward of the work.
Our section ground comes practically where this compound comes up and goes right down to...
Over in the corner there?
Yeah, there.
That's fine.
There's a three-man battery
there. This is your centre position down there. One there and one there.
Either there or that top there, so that you can see out.
It's going to be laying down. From there, what are you going to see?
Who is he cooking?
You want Harry? He's cooking.
The whole of the exercise is really quite hard, but to finish off with the log race, which we actually won, we were all dreading, and it was the longest 25 minutes of most of our lives. It was agony after about the first 50 metres. We all felt like wanting to drop because the ground was so soft, and we're all carrying packs, and it's the logs just felt like ton weight.
So. Watch what you're doing, lads, otherwise you'll break your legs.
Watch that muzzle in the ground, lad.
Thank you.
On me! Up the track!
Well, when we were told we were doing a log race just after the exercise, didn't really know what to expect. But we were last to set off and saw the other teams coming back in. They were really knackered, sweat pouring off them, you know, people hobbling around, tired muscles. I thought, oh my God, you know, because I was pretty tired at the time. My feet had big blisters on them already anyway. So anyway, we went out on a log run. We were told it was a 2 mile log run, and after about 50 metres, I was totally knackered and didn't know what to do, but we kept on going. It progressively got harder and harder and harder, and we were really knackered, and just near the end came the hill called Heartbreak Hill. And that was the worst thing I've ever done, carrying a log up there. That was really tiring, and my feet were aching, blisters, and I was sweating buckets. We had all the officers and NCOs pushing us and beasting us on, and it really hurt, but in the end we just about crawled over the line and we ended up with the best time.
I got it,
keep going.
Come on now.
They're not going to wait for you. They're going to have to catch them up.
Well done.
longest is one of the hardest things I've done. I was running exercise milk teeth and the car going, but we just had to keep going. The hardest bit it was Heartbreak Health, which was very hard. I was at the back at that time. I'd come off the log at the beginning of Heartbreak Hill, and I was fortunate enough not to take it up the hill. But I had writings and that on my back, and it was just as hard. So you know how boys felt going up that hill. The two hills, Heartbreak Hill, which was all shingle. As soon as you wanted to get to the top, you wanted to stop and rest, give up. But somehow we all drove ourselves on, screamed at each other. All our ATNCOs were there, sort of begging us to go on and feasting us. And we got to the end, not 100 metres where we could see the finish. We just all gritted our teeth and sprint for it.
Come on, Williams!
Walk down here, walk!
Come on! 3 minutes and you've won it!
Come on!
3 minutes! Don't run down here, fall over! Come on! Have your next turn!
Get off the track, Cambrai!
Come on, lads! Come on!
Come on, let's go and cheer him on. You're a whole section, you're not a half section.
Come on! 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 Come
on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Come on! Come on! Come
on! Come on! Come on! Come
on! Come on! Up to him.
Right,
what's the next one?
I want
next
question. How far is it to Barkham?
How far?
From here, Barkham's there, that's... How much? Where are we?
Just round the corner there.
Aye,
well you know where
I'm...
And then we've got to get all the bearings, decoy block, decoy block, and water tower.
The guard house is down there, isn't it? And the guard house is on there.
Oh, yeah.
So it'll be that Look, way.
There's where we are just now.
So, we are now...
Right, where are we going from here?
We've gone from the lake.
Yeah.
That's the pavilion. That's the road curving round, so we should be there, yeah? So a six-figure grid reference for that will be 77 Roma. 77.
Is that the taxi there?
No.
No, it's not the one we want. 77...
Martin Shoot competition is the most rigorous test the recruit has taken up to date. The day starts with an inspection by the commandant. Equipment is checked and then follows the 8-mile road march.
First thing was the inspection by the commandant, and we all got lined up with full combat and large packs on the way. We came around Martin and inspected it and made sure that all the webbing was on properly and we were all smartly dressed. And he went right in front of us and around the back, and all standing at attention, wondering if he's going to pick us off from anything.
And points would have been deducted if there was anything wrong from the overall score.
And was it 50 points were awarded to best turned out?
No, I think so, yeah.
And 50 points awarded to best turned out lot.
Move to the left
in foil. Left! Turn! By the right!
And after the inspection, we had like a quick kit check to make sure we had everything, didn't we?
Yeah. And they told us to get out a piece of item of kit, and for my lot it was cleaning kit. They made sure it was sparkling. It had to be sparkling. Like nylon brushes had to be pure white, and ropes for the pull through had to be really clean.
Mm. And he would choose a certain person just to come out, and then he would check all their stuff to make sure that everything was there. And they would check everything, pencils, make sure that each end was sharp, not blunt. And if there was anything missing, points would be deducted again. I think it was about 20 points per thing which was missing, damaged, not correct. And our group, we had to do it, we had hardly any time to do it in because we had to be over to start the march in 5 minutes. And if you weren't there on the right time, then points would be deducted.
Don't damage it. If it's damaged, then there can be no discrepancies in saying that you missed a checkpoint. No. You'll be deducted 25 points for every checkpoint that you miss. Anyone that doesn't complete the course from the section will have 10 minutes added onto their time and also 25 points deducted from the total score. So Smith, check him up with this.
It came the hardest bit, wasn't it? The actual march, 8 mile march in full webbing, and the time, they said you had to do it in under 2 hours, or just over the 2 hours, and the group riding did exactly 2 hours.
Whoa!
Right, come on, let's go.
Around, trying to find a way around. People looking at us as if we were complete weirdos. And that, going through all the marshlands.
Yeah, really muddy, lots of mud. We were just falling all over the place. And it was trying to keep in step because you're all in a line. And if somebody was lagging behind in the middle of the group, you'd have to turn to catch up. He would run on, and the people at the back would have to do some more running, and that would tire them out. And at times people were just shouting at each other, and it really took teamwork to get you through it. Really hard work.
It took a lot of teamwork, and you could tell that people were getting annoyed with each other because the arguments were coming out when
everyone was shouting at each other.
The pure aggression of it. You wanted to finish the course, and when you finally did, the feeling that you completed the 8 miles, it was such a feeling.
And the weather was hot that day. Mm-hmm. All the days, it had to be hot that day.
Thank you.
Chief.
Section.
One section
we had to do a sort of boat race thing across the lake, and we got into a great big boat, the whole section, and we used shovels and oars doing this. And we had to get across the other side of the lake and pick up a sandbag, and
that contained the ammunition.
Yeah, had the ammunition in it, and you were timed, time to get there and time to get back. And when we did it, we rowed across, and my section corporal jumped out, I think it was about a metre from the edge into the water, and I had to jump out myself and then turn the boat around. The water was freezing.
But it was good because everybody worked together. Definitely in our team, we were getting it all together, timings, in, out, left, more paddling, just to keep turning around. The weather wasn't too bumpy, it was quite gentle, and it wasn't too bad. It was good though. It was. You got wet though, you had to jump out of the boat, push the boat back up onto the bank.
Well, by the time you got to the other side, you were really tired. When you got actually had to push the boat back up onto the bank, it took a lot of effort. And then to finish off, you had to all line up in a straight line with your shovels, standing at attention with the shovels by your side.
And the sandbag had to be at the ATNCO's foot.
Yeah. Well done,
I need to stop.
Listen in. Just completed your march phase for competition. Remember, it's march and shoot competition, and obviously to shoot, you've got to have some sort of ammunition, which is exactly what you're going to do on this stand. You've got to collect your ammunition from the ammunition point over there. What's going to happen is as follows. You'll put on your life jackets and stand with your shovels in your right hand to attention. I want you to do that now. Make sure they're put on correctly, because you have a tendency to sink in wet combat. Right, listen in then. What's going to happen is you'll be stood to attention, shovels in the right hand as you are now. On a signal from me, which will be a whistle blast, the time will start and you will double forward, launch the boat and paddle across to the ammunition area over there. You will find there is a pile of sandbags. You will only take one sandbag for your section. Now that contains ammunition, so it does not get lost on the way back. You paddle then back to the start point with the boat dragged off onto the bank as it is now. The time will finish when you are stood in a straight line, life jackets on, shovels in right hand, with the sandbag containing the ammunition at the feet of the section commander, who will be on the right as he is now. Pretty basic. Are there any questions? Okay. Ready?
Stay! Stay! Stay!
By now we were all really tired and then came the assault course. And during PT it didn't look that bad, it was good, but when you started walking towards it, you looked at it and the walls looked high. Nobody wanted to do it, it was so tired. It looked so bad,
especially for the small people in the section. We still had weathermen by this time.
And we had to take our backpacks off.
Yeah, we took backpacks off, but we still had weathers, and you had to get the ammunition in the sandbag over the walls and all the obstacles. And for the small ones, it was a tough task. You literally threw them over the walls to get them over in a quick time. And one section, they left one person behind the wall, and they got to the end of the assault course, and the person's hands are just coming onto the wall, and they shouted to him, "Run round it." So they picked up a penalty point, because you had to go over every obstacle, didn't you?
Yeah.
Otherwise you got penalty points once again. And when you got to the end, you had to form up in a formation.
Square
formation. And then your time was taken.
Shot.
The last two events are the all-important chute and the command tank. This final event tests both mental agility and teamwork at a stage when all are very tired.
You're only allowed to go in between these two boundaries here. Again, outside of those, the white mine tape is a minefield.
But you're not allowed to go in the water?
No, you're not allowed to go in the water, okay? Going in the water, you get a minute penalty point, okay? You get all the kit, all your blokes up here. Once the kit is in the square, your men are lined up in a straight line facing me. The time will stop now. Time starts now, okay?
Sir, we're going to have to spray down. Let's check. Come on through here. Come on, that's the steer. Other stage, get in here. Let's see. Other part, the two other sides of these bollards are main field, right? So you've got to keep in these, everything, these great bollards things, right? What we've got to do, get across the other side of this stream and get these pieces of kit across there, right? And bring them back across this side, in between that, in between the bollards there, without touching the water. Across the other side. Stay inside the boundary. We need the long one, Get this through there. Make sure you dig all the seeds brown green. Someday you can get up there and climb in the tree on the other side. Remember, this log can't touch the ground in front of that main gate.
No.
Right? Let's push it through.
Right, stop there. Get the other gate through.
Let's push it. Push it through. Sorry, it's no touch the ground. Get it up. You've got to push it.
Somebody
come up here and push it so it can touch there. It's got to reach the other side.
We've got to reach the main gate, isn't it?
Go on, yeah. That's it. Whoa, over there.
Yeah.
Right, put it in there.
Come back, Colin. Don't keep the fire.
Stop! Right. That's it. Your cut-off time is 10 minutes and you've just reached it. Okay?
And the section had to do it under 5 minutes, otherwise the section would take the consequences.
The section.
Now, the section is commanded by the ATNCO, so he will take the consequences.
Corporal, in the river, 5 press-ups.
Five standing, five kneeling, okay, at the big screens, and then five again standing and kneeling at the figure 12 on it.
Ready? Ready?
Set sights, cock the weapon, sights at 300. From the standing position, declaring your shot, remembering that the shot will be indicated by the marking.
Magoff, he come out, didn't it?
Sure.
Magoff.
fire.
Okay.
Exercise Dragon Fatigue takes place in week 8. It is a 52-hour exercise designed to teach recruits individual fieldcraft, section tactics, and patrolling techniques.
If he stops for every little noise and thing, then you ain't going to get nowhere, are you? Alright? So he's got to use a bit of common sense when he's going along. If he gets a little bit suspicious, then stop, call his section commander forward, and tell him what you think's going on. He will then make his mind up what he wants to do, and then he will tell you to move. Obviously, there comes an obstacle, alright? You've got to stop. Give the sign for an obstacle, which is what? Kevin? Good lad. Tell us to get down. Stop. Obstacle. We all stop, we all get down. I come forward, have a look, and I'm going to get over it, alright? I'm getting nowhere. Remember, you can't afford if you've got 4 cases to pick all night. Because you may be given a timeout, which you will be, and a time in. And it stays that you've got me out of that time and you've got me back for that time. Because if they want you back, say, for 1 o'clock, because they might want to put an attack in at 5. So they need 4 hours to prepare for the job. Right, so you can't afford to hang about. So you must remember that. Remember also at night to use the shadows, right? Keep it into the edges. You're going down a track, keep to the left, keep to the right. And use your common sense just like you would in the day. Pick your feet up as you're going along. What I'm saying is, if you just walk normally, you will not make a noise. But if you go along and give it this, you're making too much.
Dragon Steve. Well, it's the first time we got to use blanks. First of all, we had a display of what search and patrolling techniques. Then we got issued our first blanks, 2 of them. And great big quantities, the first exercise. We used those up earlier on while practicing the techniques we were taught earlier on. But fortunately, the section sergeants have somehow managed to get hold of our rounds rather cleverly and dumped on us, so we had plenty of rounds to use. It's good fun, but a bit too hard. Especially yomping all over the place with your large pack and weather.
Yeah, we did a big bit up a hill. We went up this great big hill with a full webbing on that. Because some people made a bit of a mess of one of the fighting patrols. So we all got punished for that, but apart from that, it was quite good. We didn't get punished a lot. You know, but now and then we got ran about a bit. It was good then.
Don't you expect that anymore?
Yeah. We did a lot of practicing for the, you know, different types of ambush. And reacting to fire, that was mainly what we did on that one, on that exercise. It was good fun. We learnt a lot on that one.
Come on, you should be here now, you should be going across there. Keep the speed high, walk silently, making a lot of noise. Come on, here you go. Same time, keep the noise down. That's what your job is. Thank you.
okay? So when it's coming to crossing obstacles and things, it is your job to assist the gunner over the obstacles. Right, because he's got a heavy piece of equipment to carry there. That's why you're number two. He needs assistance. So you stick with him, okay? That's not a very good method of putting your weapon across, Bell.
Patrolling to start with, alright, and basically we're going to split it up in that we do a quick hour now, then there's going to be a lunch period where you'll get on and cook your meal, etc. And then this afternoon we're going through patrol techniques in full. We're going to do in a minute, we're going to get in our section formation and we're going to move off and go through some basic patrol techniques. Think back now, start thinking tactically, remember weapons in the shoulder at all times, alternate sides on the track depending on what formation we're in, and also then making sure that you're moving stealthily as you're going along tracks, following the contours of... wood line itself, weapons in the shoulder, sights up, observing.
I'm a member of the team, we lost the assault course competition. So what I did, all my boys were really sad and they didn't know what was happening. So what I did is I got them in the room and I sat them down and they were all dead quiet and I just said, right lads, we've just got to go for this next one. I mean, if we go for it, they're talking crates of beer and all the rest of it. And I'll say, they went out and they won it.
Yeah.
Just a bit of determination, the boys get out, no problem.
Thank you.
Come on!
Come on!
Come on! Come on! Taking the time in, they've put bets on who's going to win. My money's on me. I don't trust any of you. Okay, so Alan Aberton are going to run first. This is the red marks. There are red marks like that on the tree lap. They are everywhere. Do not bottle out on any of the obstacles. They're straightforward, stepping on something, jumping into something. As you'll see when you get there, some of it is quite a high jump into water that you don't know how deep it is. You'll see how deep it is because you'll see me go under. Hello, folks. It's all on you, all on you. Come on, I'm your
leg. Let's go again, let's go again.
Got it.
Keep the lights moving. Keep the lights moving. Keep the lights moving.
Yeah, it was good though, wasn't it?
I know,
really good. Huh?
Right, one person for Cassidy. First of all, somebody take care of him there. Right, you on the end. Go there, reassure him straight away. Right, one, two here. You two, deal with the casualty on the end there, because he's coughing and choking. Deal with that casualty there. Right, that's the priorities. Right, one, two, take him here.
No, I don't want any more, please, don't. No, no more.
We're all gonna die.
You'll be all right.
Help!
It didn't stop the bleeding. What?
Right.
Let's get you down.
Got a 200 in there, you will still get a picture. If it's a 400, then it's a
Junior Company Parents' Day. I would like to outline this morning's parade. Shortly, junior company will march on and await the arrival of the reviewing officer, Colonel A. A. Short.
Front! Ready! By the right! Make fast!
Morning, sir. Can your company is formed in open order awaiting your inspection. We have your permission to stand the company ease, place the van and elevator to the surface. Very
understandable.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you.
best apprentice tradesman in Tetragon platoon, apprentice tradesman Harry. The company commander's award for Endeavour, apprentice tradesman Ford, Tetragon platoon.
Well done.
You've done that first training before?
No, not really. Very good.
The winner of the inter-platoon drill competition, Alamein Platoon.
I mean, we must stop meeting like this on these occasions. Especially when I'm sold on.
Starting from our left and on the right of the parade is C Company Green, our champion company, A Company Blue, B Company Red, C Company Yellow. They will remain C Companies throughout their apprenticeship. Thank you.
skill, daring, and precision performed by any army. For those of you with sons or relations in the company, rest assured that we have an extremely good safety record. In fact, the most serious injury you have yet sustained during one of our rehearsals is a broken fingernail. During the next 20 minutes or so, you may find that you have the most overpowering urge to applaud. For safety reasons, please restrain yourself until we get to do so by our prompter. On the 15th of December 1986, the college establishment was increased by 185 ex-skinheads. Thank you.
into your right pocket. I'm taking hold of her handkerchief, making sure that it's only the handkerchief you take hold of. On the command two, you remove the handkerchief from your pocket and place it against your nose. On the command three, you will blow three times. On the command four, you will remove the handkerchief from your nose and place it into your right pocket. From this position, you will adopt position five with the handkerchief into the right pocket. Are there any questions? I can hear you. Good. Here we go. One.
Slow.
Two.
Three.
Do
you have to, Sergeant?
Of course you do, boy. Of course you do. And what, pray, are those?
Sergeant.
Fine. Three. Four. Five. Squad will kneel. Kneel.
The Sunday, week two, brought the first competition to the prestigious Victor Zoran Trekking. This came in the form of a 4-mile cross-country run in which all the boys took part.
Right! Come on! Keep moving!
How to march, shall I? Right. You put your left leg forward like that and your right arm out.
And you do the same like that. Ready? Quick march. That's it.
We came, and by now the boys were ready to attempt exercise Dragon's Teeth, a patrolling exercise, carried out in a hostile area of the sun. in such a wide variety of activities. Please now applaud your summons.
the jump right. Turn, kick it away, go.
Junior company, high horse displacing.
Displacing, cadet, go!
In our platoon competition, has played a major part in the course. This is the gun race. For the four platoons, they each have produced a team whose task it is to negotiate the course that you will now see being laid out. The prize teams are competing for is the home quest flag.
To march intake 86C on the parade, sir, please.
Okay.
Intake 86C! Outward! Turn! Fire up front! Double! March!
Thank you.
This was good though, wasn't it?
I know.
Really good.
Thank you.